This is Evan from Wausau. Long time no see. Here's an episode of EHC's Tabletop. It's been a long time, and there's been reasons for that. Partly and primarily, I've been very busy with a lot of different things in my personal life. Specifically, a pretty significant life change career-wise. That's kind of been dominating my time while I'm still wrapping things up with my current job, which also happens to be the busiest time of the year. So kind of getting that prep for the new person coming on board, making sure that transition goes well. It's dominated my time for the last number of months. But I'm here today because it's a great excuse to get in front of you and talk and reconnect because it's that time of year again. Last year I got online, recorded one of my first videos associated with the Palladium Books Christmas surprise package or holiday grab bag, however you want to describe that. And thanks to that excitement and the grab bags allowing me to get back into the hobby in terms of building up my library, I was able to meet some pretty cool people. Eric Bloat, Jody over at Questwise, Jeff over at the One Shot group, folks who I've been able to connect with, get to know, and have been able to game with. It's been pretty great. And, you know, I would not have known those folks if it wasn't for these videos. So let's get to it. Let's see what I got this year. It's a little different this year than last year regarding the price. Last year it was $45. This year it's $46. Palladium Books guarantees you $90 to $95 of product, if not more. You basically fill out a wish list of 10 items or more. And the gang over at Palladium Books pull together a package that you know takes into account your list, but sometimes they'll surprise you with other things as well. So let's see what I got. First things first, I did want to let you know what I requested this year. This will be my only surprise package this year. Last year I got four. I don't need four this year. I'm just getting one this year. So what I requested, number one, was the TMNT Game Shield, long out of print. The only reason I'm requested it is because I saw some copies at the Palladium Books open house. And if there are any left, I'm hoping I can, if I'm lucky, maybe get a copy. We'll see. Nightbane Between the Shadows, a great source book. I used to have it. I recently reacquired Nightbane, and Between the Shadows is just a splendid source book, and I'd love to acquire that. Palladium RPG, Library of Breathrod, that is, again, a book I used to have. Wonderful source book. Library of Breathrod is off the east of the eastern region, the eastern territories, and it's just a really cool source book. Lots of cool, I seem to recall, ruin weapons and other mystical weapons and some great history. Imagine like this great epic library, and that's what this is, outlining the history of the Palladium fantasy world. And, you know, thanks to that, a lot of cool, neat gizmos and knickknacks and, you know, items of interest. Four, I requested Rifts Atlantis, a new copy of that. Five, Rifts Aftermath. That was the book that was released after the Coalition Wars series 10, 15 years ago. It basically outlined the status quo of Rifts Earth following that, which was the big change from the initial Rifts RPG. I've always been curious about that. Rifts the Black Vault, that's one of the Chi-Town source books. Basically, it's the vault that the Coalition keeps to of magical items that they've confiscated. So that should, if I get that, have some neat items. The ZD6 Invasion, that book, I've always been intrigued by the Zit-Tixix and what they're all about. You know, Rifts' version of like the aliens from the Alien movies, or maybe their version of the Invid from Robotech. The next one I requested was Aliens Unlimited, great source book outlining a whole bunch of aliens that you can utilize in all the different settings. The next one I requested was the Palladium RPG Second Ed. I've had, and I've shown you the revised edition that I really adore, but a lot of people do use the Palladium Fantasy RPG Second Ed rules, and figured I might as well just have a copy of that, just to simplify rolling up characters and conversions if I ever have a chance to play in a game like that. And then last but not least, I requested the Palladium t-shirt, that Palladium Fantasy t-shirt that has the original cover from the first early editions of the Palladium Fantasy RPG, where basically things all began for Palladium after Mechanoids. So that's what I requested. You know, these are all items, no matter what I get, these are all things I want, they're all worthwhile things. Let's get to it. Let's see what I ended up getting here. So, okay, doing good with time. I'm going to try not to be too verbose. So now that we got all that out of the way, now we can just get to the product. I took my X-Acto knife, cut the tape so I can flip this open. We'll get to it. And here we go. Cool. I ended up getting the Palladium t-shirt with the design that I was mentioning to you. Very cool. It's cool to have a game-related t-shirt to wear to cons, and if I ever make it to another Palladium Books open house, it'd be great to be able to wear this. They didn't have medium anymore, but they did have large. I prefer mediums, but they do have a large here. Let's take a look at it. It's a beautiful, just a great shirt. There you go. Yeah, Palladium Fantasy, living the fantasy, Palladium Books. So that's very cool. I look forward to wearing that. Packing slip. Information about the surprise package. Info about upcoming things. Checklist. And let's see what I got. Score! I got it. Long out of print, a game shield that I can, that I just want for my collection, that I could maybe even use. So that's really cool, the TMNT and Other Strangeness game shield. Super awesome. I think it also comes with a booklet. Yep, a booklet and accessory pack with some adventures. So that's awesome. So already right there, that's pretty great. That's fantastic. Oh. Got the Black Vault book, which, again, I think will have some cool stuff in it. And the other cool thing you can request with the surprise packages is autographs and signatures from the staff. It's kind of fun to do. And if tradition holds, Simbita will always write an individual kind of catchphrase for each one. So, yeah, there we go. Got the signatures, and it says, Beware the Coalition. Kevin, Alex, Wayne, and Julius. Very cool. Okay, they threw in a Rifter. Is this one of the newer ones? I think this must be one of the newer ones. Let's see. Oh, wow, this has a lot in it. A lot of autographs. It's got, it says Living the Fantasy, Kevin, Wayne, Alex, Julius. I don't know that signature. Walden, pretty cool. And then someone's little stamp as well. So that's cool. This is neat. And this was printed August 2018. So if this isn't the newest Rifter, it was the one just before last. So it's always nice to have a copy of the Rifter. It's just a neat little time capsule of Palladium Books at that moment. There's always some good information. And one of these days, who knows, maybe I'll try to submit something. I keep hoping that that Eric and or Jody will try to write something and submit it to the Rifter. That'd be really cool for those guys. Next book I got, Atlantis. Riff's Atlantis. Fantastic. One of their earliest world books. Long been in print for a long time. Great information. Glad to have it and have a nice new copy. And here is Otto's graphs and signatures. This one just says best, Kevin. Alex, Julius, and Wayne. And then I got Beyond the or Between the Shadows for Nightbane. Very cool to have this. This is I think it's probably one of the best source books Palladium has ever released. It's definitely a fine book. A lot of great information in it. Obviously, to be used primarily with Nightbane, but could easily be used with Beyond the Supernatural and any of the other Palladium products out there, with some conversions probably. And there we go. Autographs and signatures. Game on, Kevin Singita, Alex, and Julius. So there we go. Let's see if I can do a head count on all this. Okay, so let's see let's put the t-shirt at $20. This was priced at $20, so we got $40. $55. $65. $85. And $105. So I got $105 worth of product for $46 plus handling and shipping. Pretty good score. And I'm really thrilled again to have this. The cool thing, if you do decide to do an order, and I'll put a link down below, this year, unlike other years from what I've seen, is they actually they mention out-of-print items as things you can request. That said, it's specific out-of-print items. So check that out. Last year, they explicitly said no out-of-print books. This year, there's a handful of out-of-print books that they are encouraging people to make request on the chance they might get it. So look into that. So thanks again for humoring me as I opened this up. If any of you out there end up getting a surprise package this season, 2018, I hope you do an unboxing video. They're great to see. They're fun. They're inspiring. It gets you some new product to kind of dig into and get you excited about gaming with friends and family. So that's that. Evan from Wausau. Take care and happy gaming. Bye.